Okay, welcome back to my new route tutorial. I was asked one question, whether it's possible to explain how to find the root of a function in root. And in principle, it's very simple. There are many methods or many possible methods how to do that. And I think I will explain now the easiest one. And yeah, with the help of that method, then it's also possible to use more complicated ones. But I think I will just directly start by creating a new file, and let's call it tutorial 27, since we reached there already. And now we can first define a new function with the help of the tf1 class that I have introduced already before, and we just call this function maybe f. And yeah, then we have to write, as usual, new tf1. Then we have to give the name of the function, which is in this case maybe just f, it doesn't matter so much. And then we have to define the function itself. So I want to make it very simple by just defining a cosine function maybe. So we can define an amplitude with 0, I mean the parameter 0. Then we can actually define the function with cosine. And then we can use another parameter 1 plus x, and with the help of this parameter then we can shift the cosine function to the left and to the right, which is especially important to prove that our method of finding the root is important, is working. And it works also not only with standard functions but also with any kind of function that you can imagine. Okay, then we have to set limits. In fact, for finding the root of this function, it's not important to do it because there we have to set the interval a little bit later. But for the purpose of drawing, I think it's always beneficial to put it. So later then we can check whether everything was working correctly. So now in the next step, we define the parameters. So let's suppose parameter 0 should be 1. So we can also omit it basically, but later you can also play around with that to check whether it also works by changing or varying some of the parameters. And now the other parameter, we can also set any arbitrary value there, but let's suppose we want to use 1, so the whole function would be shifted by 1 to the left, as we will see later. And now we can just create a new canvas as usual, and we can draw that function in order to check whether we have done any mistake and how the function in principle looks like in order to find the root or the roots of the function. So when I run this script, it looks like that, and you see here that the baseline 0 is basically here, and you can already estimate where the function hits that baseline, so or intersects with that. So 1 is maybe very close to -3, and 1 is maybe very close to 0.5, something like that. And now we can actually start with the with the algorithm to find the root. And we can write here root math and then root finder. So the namespace is basically called root math, and there are many classes and functions implemented here. There's a very important namespace. And then the name of the class that we have to use is called root finder, and we have to of course create an object which we call maybe finder. And then the member function which we have to use from that is called solve. And now we have to reference that function. So if we create it on the heap, we have to write here this star f, or if we create it on the stack, then it's sufficient if you write f, but here in this case we have to write it in such a way. And then we have to set a lower and an upper limit of the interval in which the root finder will search for the root. In this case, as we said, it was very close to -3, I guess. So we can first set it to in between to -5 to 0. And we can then check whether it works. So in order to do that, we have to get access to the root, and maybe we create here double, which we call solution. And then we can write here finder.root, and this function returns the last root which has been found by that function. So and actually we can write it out here just in the terminal to check whether it worked. And when you do that, you can find here -2.57 and so on. And maybe we can also visualize that to make it easier to identify. So, and to practice also how to draw lines. So we can actually create a new T line here, and we can draw it from -5 to 5, similar to the limits which we have set here. And then the first line should be at y equals to 0. So we get the horizontal line, which is the baseline. And then we can actually also draw that. Now you can see here where the intersection points are. And then we just create another line, L2. And this should be then at the x position where we calculated our solution, -2, and then it should stay at the same x position up till maybe +2. You can also adjust that a little bit to make it more beautiful, but for the time being it's okay. Now you can see that the solution which has been found is the correct one. It's exactly on the intersection point here. And now to show how you can find also the other roots of the function, you can in this case just again use again this member function solve with respect to the function f, and then we can choose the next interval, maybe 0, 5. So it's always important to plot this function to see where the roots can be, and then later you can set the interval according to that to make sure that root will find it. And maybe we can also copy this command here to here, and we can maybe create another solution 2, we call it, and we have to write here finder.root again. So this is the last root which has been found, and here we have to see out solution number 2. And also to check whether it is correct, we can create a new line here, which we call now maybe line 3, and or L3, and this should have the x value solution 2. And then we can write here L3 draw, and hopefully I didn't do any mistake in copying and pasting everything. Yes, so it also works here. We have here the second root and so on, and now you can extend this to the whole function which you have, and then actually you will find the root everywhere. You can also use then these limits to calculate the integral in between, for example. There are many possibilities what you can do, and there are also other functions available or other classes. One is, for example, multi-root finder. Then you have to put a little bit more effort in changing them or adopting the macro according to that, but it's also not so difficult, and it will find you then an array, or will give you an array of roots. Nevertheless, it's a little bit more complicated, and I would say that maybe this will be part of another video if you are interested in that. But for the time being, I will stick to that easy solution which you have here, because it always works, I think, for most of the functions. And you can try this by changing some parameters, the functions and so on, to check whether it does not fail anywhere. With this short explanation, I want to close the video now. I hope that you learned something. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. Please put the comments, questions into the comment section. And if you have not subscribed until now, then you can maybe subscribe my channel. Thank you very much for your attention.